Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi everyone, we are from group 7 and let us introduce ourselves. My name is Ardelia Putri from class B, attendance number 7.
My name is Muhammad Yaya Mahendra, I am from class B. My number presentation is 27.
Hello, my name is Satria Pabudi. Attendance number 36. I am from class B.
Hello, Ardel.
Hi.
How was your day, sis?
Thanks God, I'm good. How about you guys?
Alhamdulillah, we are good.
Okay, let's go into the question session. Maybe it can be started from the question, what is sandwich generation? Because a lot of people don't know what sandwich generation is.
Okay, straight to the point question. I give you an analogy. When you have young children, of course you have to support your child. On the other hand, you also have parents who are unemployed and unproductive. Like it or not, you have to support your parents. Since you have to support the lives of your children and parents, you can be called the sandwich generation. And I was in that position.
Wow, it's really hard being the sandwich generation. You must have been through a lot of trouble in your life.
Yep, it's quite heavy. But like it or not, it's my responsibility.
So the main problem is related to money, right?
Yes, that's right. Money is the main issue here. Because we have to have an income, and that income must be served to support our parents, children, and ourselves.
Very cool. Now, if you might know, what is your family background like?
Incidentally, my parents were only entrepreneurs, and now they don't work anymore. They don't have a pension fund, so I have to pay for their living in old age.
What about the children? How many children do you have?
I have two young children. The first child is 5 years old. The second one is 1 year old.
Can you tell us a little how was sleep before husband and having children?
When I was single, I could still fulfill my parents' life. Then, when I had children, I began to be confused about how to control them, how to plan the best for my child, keep my parents happy, and make myself happy too. And besides, I have to be zen.
Can it be called a mental shock? Because you are shocked by the gen which used to only think of making your parents happy, but now you have children.
Mental shock. I don't know what it was called, but at the time, I made me confused. Even I blame myself. Why didn't I start saving, investing? And I thought that I was a victim of them.
So it's no hurt yourself, huh? Let it be said this becomes something negative because it can affect our work or relationship with our husband, work becomes unproductive, and so on.
Yes, that is right. At that time, discussing finance was a sensitive matter. Even my relationship with my husband has become sensitive too.
Oh, can't imagine how you became. Thankful I did not experience the sandwich generation, but I also know I have to fight myself. So I made your story as a motivation for me fighting.
Really? Especially the money issue looks like we have prepared from now on for our future, and don't forget to manage finance.
Yeah, managing finance is very important, especially investment, because it will be beneficial for long term.
Well, then how is it going?
It was a point when I didn't want to have a bad relationship with my parents. I have to fix the relationship with my parents and also about money. I came to training because I felt I needed help, and also I didn't want to have an unhealthy viewpoint on myself and my parents. Finally, I tried to have the courage to communicate with my parents so that our financial plans are good for me, them, and also my child.
In the end, communication is very important. No matter how big the problem is, even if it can be discussed properly, it will definitely be resolved.
Yeah, that's right.
Wow. We have talked a lot about sandwich generation from Ardell's point of view. Maybe thing you want to say for yourself, those who are struggling in this sandwich generation?
For myself, I can call it, I'm proud to be sandwich generation. And for friends out there who are in a sandwich generation state, please keep up the spirit and try to stay sane. Communication is important in this regard, and also transparency is everything.
Wow. Thank you very much to Ardell for sharing his story in this interview session. There are many things we can take from the story earlier. Hopefully, it will be useful for all of you, especially those in the sandwich generation position.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Saudara, generasi kejepit atau sandwich generation banyak terjadi di Indonesia. Generasi ini terjepit antara harus membiayai orang tua dan keluarga sendiri. Rantai sandwich generation bisa diputus dengan pendidikan keuangan yang baik sejak dini. Thank you.
The sandwich generation is those who are sequenced by two generations, after and before, to support both of them. Here is the easiest to understand examples of sandwich generation.
The main problem in this generation is finance, because the income we have must be shared with our children and our parents. Being the sandwich generation can cause mental shock, because you have to deal with quite severe and sensitive problems.
So if you are trapped in this generation, managing finance and investing is very important, because being the sandwich generation is not as easy as we think.
A 7.3 magnitude earthquake struck just about 35 kilometers underwater, as you just mentioned, and that is just off the coast of Indonesia. But I want to make it perfectly clear, there is no longer a tsunami threat with this particular earthquake that occurred about an hour and 45 minutes ago. I've been checking all social media avenues and
2021 Indonesia dilanda beberapa bencana alam dalam kurun waktu 3 minggu. BNPB mencatat setidaknya mulai dari 1 hingga 21 Januari 2021 ada 185 kejadian bencana alam yang terjadi di Indonesia. Pada Sabtu malam tanggal 9 Januari 2021, tanah longsor terjadi di Desa Cihanjuang, Cimanggung, Sumedang, Jawa Barat. Longsor terjadi 2 kali. Kita bergeser ke Kalimantan. Karena cuaca buruk yang terjadi di sejumlah wilayah Indonesia juga mengakibatkan banjir di sejumlah wilayah di Kalimantan Selatan sejak 14 Januari 2021.
Recently, Indonesia has been breathing again. Various natural disasters have occurred in several regions in Indonesia, ranging from flash floods, landslides, earthquakes, to volcanic eruptions. Indonesia is a country surrounded by the Pacific Ring of Fire, with 139 volcanoes. This is what makes the basic motion of the Indonesia Earth so active. Indonesia is also located on the Alpit Belt Line, which is the second most active earthquake route in the world. It doesn't stop there. Indonesia is also flanked by three continental plates. And finally, Indonesia is a tropical country, which is one of the triggers for natural phenomena.
Natural disaster can happen at any time. No sign, no sound. To reduce the risk, prepare a survival bag in your home. In fact, there are still many residents who don't understand about self-mitigation and preparation for this survival bag. Let us explain. The survival bag is an emergency bag containing survival equipment to support survival while in a disaster post.
The contents of the survival bag are: number 1, mineral water for everyone. Number 2, food that is not perishable and durable. Number 3, flashlight. Number 4, radio powered by battery. Number 5, extra battery. Number 6, family first aid kit. Number 7, medicines. Number 8, multi-purpose knife. Number 9, sanitary and personal hygiene kits. Number 10, copies of personal documents. Number 11, cell phones and chargers. Number 12, extra cash. Number 13, sleeping bag.
There are also additional equipment, including baby gear, walkie-talkies, whistle, gas mask, raincoat, and gliders. Apart from having to be prepared for natural disaster, we also need to keep emergency telephone numbers: 110 for the police, 100 118 and 119 for ambulance, 130 and 1131 for firefighters, and 115 for National Search and Rescue Agency. So, take disaster mitigation to save your life.